ran an online magazine called BustedHalo.com, which was for spiritual seekers. One summer, I said, well, we need something for back to school. I had one of my contributing editors say, well, just for what it's worth, she's a youth minister up in Rochester. And she said, for what it's worth, I've been doing this for 15 years. And I've seen so many kids that I've sent off from youth ministry off to college that have crashed and burned, that I've started bringing kids that are already gone and come back and live to tell the tale, and have the college kids answer any questions that the seniors have, and also tell it to them straight what college is really like. And the light went off for me right then. It's like, that's brilliant. We could do like just a listing that you could post on your dorm room wall, and we'll call it the Freshman Survival Guide, a checkpoint. We wanted to really get the wisdom from students themselves. And so a lot of it grew out of just comments coming back to us and asking students, what do you think about this? And it's amazing how helpful a lot of the upperclassmen wanted to be, because they also experienced some of these. A lot of the book is really a lot of people's own sort of cautionary tales, stuff I did that I barely survived, or that I had messed up.
I'm going to tell you about going to see your teachers. Misconception, freshmen, your teachers actually want to talk to you. They have office hours, and usually no one shows up. Use them as a resource. They're there for you. Cool?
For the first few weeks, live like a monk. And that chapter always gets a lot of laughs. It's really just a way to hook you in to say that, you know, monks have they take vows of poverty, chastity, and obedience. What does that mean for the college freshman for poverty? It means you're going to get a lot of offers for credit cards, and they now can sign for themselves over 18 for their own credit cards. We really strongly advise that students are extremely cautious about how they use their credit and how they spend their money, because the day of reckoning comes, and it can be devastating for a lot of people. Chastity is always sort of a good one. People kind of snicker at that, but what that is really saying is that, you know, for a lot of times this is the first time people have a room away from their parents, and nobody's going to care, you know, who they bring home. We advise students to be smart. There are a lot of broken hearts and souls and careers that happen early on because all this freedom, and people don't know how far they've hung themselves out. The obedience part really comes down to, like, go to class. It's like you're there for a reason. The single greatest predictor of failure is going to class. You know, you're spending this money. It's good money. It's hard-earned money. And this is a real key to your future. And take advantage of it and be smart. We wanted the book to be sort of one part of an experience that would be a multimedia experience, really, and to be a more interactive experience. So our book, every chapter has a section called the Online Survival Guide, where we push them online for different features that aren't in the book, that couldn't fit in the book. Well, it's a book and it's in your hand. It also has a tremendous element of sort of growing and sort of being crowdsourced and interactivity and dialogue going on.